The emotionally charged case of a mentally ill man who was shot and killed by New South Wales Police was back before the coroner today. Not surprisingly, the partner of the officer who pulled the trigger insisted they did nothing wrong. And so far, prosecutors have agreed. Ellie Southwood has more.
Former police officer Greg Duffy was never given an order to arrest Elijah Holcombe, but maintains he and his partner had good reason to pursue the mentally ill man because they believed he needed to get back to hospital and was responsible for a stolen car. CCTV captured Mr. Duffy's partner, Senior Constable Andrew Rich, in pursuit. Minutes later, he shot Elijah Holcombe in the chest. Today, Elijah's family was at the coroner's court for the resumption of an inquest into his death.
Not only the family, but the public really want to know what occurred on that day.
Just 2 days before Elijah died, he stopped taking his medication and took off in his father's car. Mr. Holcombe reported his son missing and warned officers of Elijah's paranoia and fear of police. The next day, Elijah handed himself in and an officer took him to hospital. But Elijah discharged himself, and when he was chased by Senior Constables Duffy and Rich, he ran through a cafe and armed himself with a bread knife. Senior Constable Rich kept chasing and then fired.
This inquest actually began in Armidale in 2010, where the vast majority of witnesses said Elijah never threatened or moved towards the officer. That prompted the coroner to suspend the inquest and refer the case to the DPP to consider laying charges against Senior Constable Rich.
The officer who fired the shot is due to give evidence tomorrow.
Well, I think Constable Rich is the one who's able to give answers to the great unknown, and that is why he did what he did.
Ellie Southwood, 10 News.